yo, what it do is poppin'. It's the Kill Bum leaking on deck with that heat. Working on get down if you new here. Make sure you subscribe to the gang if you lame. You can't hang out, I won't bang with you. Hey, bro, so apparently last video I reacted to Pretty Boy the Fredo diss track. And I missed a key bar. Everybody in the comments is talking about some Fredo diss. DDG dead brother. I went back and listened to the song. Didn't even catch this. I missed the whole part. Pretty Boy Fredo live. Fredo talking about he didn't diss his dead brother. He said he was talking directly to him. I feel like it had to go that far based off the simple fact that this beef over basketball. You know? I feel like y'all should have just scoped it out. And DG responded, we finna check this out. This alive, by the way.
And it matter. Niggas thought they was finna go platinum or something, or they was finna go gold or something, but you know, I shut that shit down quick, but. I ain't gonna speak on no
more. Oh yeah, that nigga had took. I had seen he had took the video down. You feel me? And that's I'm telling you, bro. People be steady telling niggas to react to this, react to that, bro. But it's like you don't have no control over what's gonna happen. You know what I'm saying? You do it, but you don't have no control over what's gonna happen. Like somebody could easily copyright you or take your shit down or block that bill worldwide, and you put in all that work. All that effort for nothing, and I know that video took effort this and that, and you know what I'm saying, just to get took down, bro, who finna sit here and do that? You know what I'm saying? Like, people stay spamming me with a reaction. I'm like, dude, niggas don't get that though.
No more,
real talk.
You said too much. It's at a point of time, you know, it gets to a point where it's past entertainment. You know what I'm saying? It get past entertainment at one point, and it's like, okay, it ain't no more boxing. I was trying to give you, you know, the respect and fight you on some, you know, on some YouTube shit, whoop, and then we could have made some money. But now you want to get online and you want to, nigga flew to Michigan, bro. Then nigga, look, let me tell y'all how to get to Pontiac. You have to fly to
DTW. That nigga did go to Pontiac, though,
Detroit,
on nigga. Game.
First of all, nigga wasn't even in Pontiac. Nigga was in Bloomfield. Matter of fact, the nigga was in Bloomfield. Look. So you have to fly to Pontiac. I mean, you had to fly to Detroit, right? Pontiac is a 45-minute no traffic drive from Detroit. So that means this nigga rented a car, right?
So that about an hour.
This nigga rented a car, right? First of all, before this nigga went to New York, the nigga was in New York. When the nigga was in New York, this nigga stopped traffic, probably got a fucking fine. The nigga stopped the whole highway to record this goddamn music video.
Hey, no cap. I did see that this nigga had like buku. Like I was watching it again. This nigga had buku Suburbans and all that in the background. You hear me? Like security trucks and this and that. I guess they was blocking the traffic so they could do what they was doing. Cause I wonder how they were cutting up on that bridge like this, man.
Weird ass shit, bro. Niggas be weirdo. And then this nigga hops on a plane, goes to Detroit, drives 45 minutes to Pontiac. Hops on top of the Pontiac sign with a fat nigga and sing
dang,
a diss track about
the keys,
me.
Man.
Paid a videographer. He flew out the fat nigga, the videographer, and then the nigga flew to wherever he at now, got the video back, waited for this moment, premiered the video, dropped it. Everybody, he reposting everybody on the story. Just to get his shit taken down. Goofball bitch.
Hey,
niggas is retarded,
son,
bro. Niggas
like, exactly. Niggas be, hey, son, like, you could do the most, you feel me, just to do something and your video get taken down, my nigga. Like, no cap. Like, that's really when I started getting aggravated with the reactions, bro. I feel like they ain't got a person on YouTube that had as many copyrights and blocked videos as me on gang. Like, son, it's a lot of videos on my channel that don't even show, that y'all can't even see. Man, I got buku channels. I can show y'all right now. Block worldwide, block worldwide, block worldwide. You know what I'm saying? I just delete them bitches, you know what I'm saying? Cause it's like all at work, you know what I'm saying? And y'all know I be rocking out, so it's like real talk.
The shit he doing, I did that shit in 2017, nigga. I passed that bitch. You know what I'm saying? Niggas on the cover of fucking on Spotify and shit, bro. I'm not trying to do this shit no more. Niggas trying to bring me into this weak ass, corny ass YouTube drama, bro. I'm not a part of that bullshit no more. Y'all niggas see
them
on a whole different way. Niggas see them on a whole different vibe. I'm not even on that shit no more, bro. This shit is childish. Niggas is grown as fuck. Niggas is 28 and up. Niggas got kids. You got kids, bitch. The fuck is you doing? Let me have a daughter at the crib, bro. I'm not running around with no little ass boys. What the fuck?
Hey, I'm gonna keep it real though. I'm gonna let that be real.
Bro, nigga is weird, bro. Y'all don't see that shit. This nigga's mental. He needs help. Seriously, needs help. I would never. Nigga, I don't even live in Pontiac, bitch. I don't live in Pontiac. The only thing I see in Pontiac is that, nigga. Niggas know where I'm from. I don't live there no more. I live in a mansion. Your crib, the size of his crib is not fucking with this. Nigga, listen, I don't have no kids, no nothing. I got enough space to move Fredo and his whole family in my crib, bro. Free. And I ain't even got,
we need a charger.
Did y'all hear that? I wouldn't even have to see that man. And this nigga, I can move him, Jasmine, and his daughter. And I never ever said anything about the nigga daughter, bro. The nigga got a beautiful daughter. I would never speak on a kid, bro. She has nothing. But you are a bitch.
Didn't say nothing about his daughter.
You're a bitch ass father. You need to fix yourself. You need to motherfucking, whatever the fuck it's called, nigga. You need to fucking, I don't know. You need to change up how you acting, bro. Because this shit is embarrassing. This shit is embarrassing. I'm 22 years old, bro. And I'm doing much better than you. Get off my dick. The fuck is you on here making screenshot DMs and bro, these niggas is soft, bro. That's why I don't associate myself with any of the YouTube shit.
Them niggas took that video down, too. I had watched that video when it dropped yesterday. That was like yesterday morning. I was still in bed. It probably went in the morning. It was probably like about 12 or something. But I had watched that bit, too. He had the DMs talking about DDG had told him that, you know what I'm saying? Man, what he said? Man, he said something like it's past boxing, you hear me? It was something like that, like it's really like that now, you feel me? So, that's what that was on, but shit, I understand, you hear me, nigga? It would have been like that with us too, I'm gang.
Blah, blah, all the other shit, bro. Like,
it probably would have been like that from the start.
Do YouTube videos and shit, it's really by myself or my family, because these niggas is weird. These niggas is weird, bro. These niggas is weird. And then I went online, bro, and I seen this girl. Some girl said that this nigga left her for a nigga.
I seen that on Twitter.
I knew the nigga was sweet.
I seen that on Twitter.
I knew he was sweet.
I seen that on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter, fruit,
bro. He posts butterfly emojis. Like,
I don't tweet.
Y'all don't see straight through this, bro. This nigga's weird, bro. Like, and I hate niggas always try to beef with me on the internet because they know it get views. But every single nigga that beef with me on the internet loses. Because I don't bother nobody. Everybody come for me. Nigga, I don't come at... I never go out my way to sneak diss or diss on another man, bro. I'm too focused. Like, this nigga was online talking about me for no reason. Now it's past the boxing. I'm not boxing that nigga.
Yeah, that's what he said. It's past
the boxing. Fuck that nigga, bro. He don't deserve no goddamn cushion in these punches. That nigga, he all bone, nigga. Bitch ass nigga.
No nigga told that boy he won't feel.
I want to talk about his brother. I really talk about that. Niggas is scared now, bro. Pussy ass nigga, your shit's gone. You did all that shit. You spent 10K plus on a motherfucking music video, and I took that shit down, bitch. I could have. You know what I could have did? I could have motherfucking. I could have took all the nigga money. I could have just copyrighted and let it keep it up. But I was like, you know what? I'm gonna take all your shit down. I'm gonna take your shit down, dumb bitch. You did all that work. You want to drive a Pontiac like a goofball? Yeah, I'm gonna take that shit. I need that. Take that down.
Telling you, bro. You listening to it? You listening to it? You doing videos? Like, what's the point of doing like videos and like a nigga could literally just take your shit, take your money, take this and that, especially if. You know what I'm saying? I just started doing YouTube full time, you know what I'm saying? So I really can't go for that. But you know what I'm saying? At the time, I wasn't tripping because I'm working. You know what I'm saying? I'm just doing this. But now it got to the point where I'm trying to do this full time. So I can't be going.
If you
want to
make another video, I need that. Take that down. I'm bullying this nigga. He's older than me. These niggas
straight up,
pussy,
that's how
man.
That should be going, man.
I'm chilling, bro. I don't bother nobody. I don't never play fake gangster, none of that shit, bro. I just be chilling. I just be chilling. These niggas is lame, bro. These niggas is lame as fuck.
That shit that crazy. That these two niggas really beefing like that, you know what I'm saying?
I hopped on this bitch. I just hopped off the plane. I just got back from Atlanta. Hop on live, 30,000 niggas in here trying to see what I'm talking about. So I just had to, you know, give y'all a little bit of content and shit. You know, that's all it was for real. But that nigga's a bitch. I don't even want to speak on him. I don't even know his name. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, life is good. I had a lot of fun in Atlanta.
Well, see, well, we basically got everything we needed to get out this video. I don't want it to be too long, you know what I'm saying? But, hey, I'm going to keep it true, though. Like, I'm going to keep it all the way gangster, you feel me? I seen some people talking about, there are some people in my comments on the reaction to the, you know what I'm saying, to the diss track. Niggas like, oh, you on Fredo's side? I got to unsubscribe. This nigga, for one, if that's how I know niggas ain't watched the whole video. Because, nigga, for one, I said neutral in this situation. Did I not say that? I probably said that like 3 times. I'm fans of both of these niggas. I ain't picking no side, nigga. I'm fans of both. I told you it's like the JD Young and NBA Youngboy situation. I've been rocking with both them niggas. Them niggas just started beefing. That shit ain't got nothing to do with me. Don't got nothing to do with me. Like, people be thinking that shit got something to do with them. They gotta pick a side. This and that. This and that. Man, that shit ain't got nothing to do with you. That's they beef. That's they beef. You know what I'm saying? People don't be getting that shit, though. But to keep it G, I feel like, oh, beef shit, that, like, they been starting to get, like, dragged, you know what I'm saying? Like, DDG trying to get straight to the business. Fredo talking about to December 31st. You really don't need that long to get it up in blood. If you really beefing with a nigga. Like, y'all used to the old Fredo. Like, you ever watched Disney Channel before? And you used to watch it, like for example, Miley Cyrus. I don't even know if that was on Disney or whatever it was on, you hear me? Miley Cyrus. She was like so like, she was like perfect petty, you know what I'm saying? She like perfect petty. That's the image that she got out, you feel me? So when she get older and she start doing regular shit that everybody else do, you know what I'm saying? You got the media, this and that, now they looking at her like she gone crazy and doing all type of other shit when she really on some regular shit. You don't ever see that, like Disney Channel people and this and that be on some like wilding out type shit, but they really be doing some old normal shit. Some of them be crashing out, but most of the time it just be some, like they feel like when they do something wrong, it's just abnormal, you know what I'm saying? They regular people too. That's the type of image Fredo had, you know what I'm saying, in the beginning. So I guess that's why people be talking about he changed. But to keep it G, if you really look at the videos, that nigga the same. That nigga was doing the same shit, you know what I'm saying? It was just more, he was more clean with it. Now he's a little more loose with it. I don't think they having no boxing match no more. Obviously, DDG say that's over with. How many lit videos y'all want me to react to? HBM.